to the, well, it's not going to really be cold, but an away game, first time in a long time, and a different atmosphere.
Right. Cooler. I think it's good for us to get a little change up, you know, go on the road, you know, just us out there in the locker room, just the guys, go out there, you know, rebound and get a W.
Without Jeff, I mean, how much more, I guess, do you have to be ready to play more snaps? I mean, I guess, you know, some of the guys like Mark Pope, Mike Harley, like, do you just have to take more shoulder upon yourself, the load, so to speak, more snaps, that sort of thing?
Oh, I think I seen that last game. My snaps went up a little bit. But, I mean, all the guys, you know, we all can step up. You know, I think it's good for those guys to, you know, they get a chance to see Wiggs caught a big post. Again, like Mark Pope making plays, Harley making plays. It's a chance for other guys to step up, but you know, I really can, you know, I feel like take the load off of some of those guys.
Brian Hightower, I guess, decided to transfer, and you obviously got to know him a little bit. I'm wondering how much you talked to him about all that decision before he decided it, and what do you sort of say to the other guys in the room, you know, who want a chance to play and haven't maybe played as much as they wanted?
Right, I didn't talk to him about the transfer thing. I'm gonna miss him though. You know, I mean, you know, this thing happening so fast. I say I'm gonna miss him, but I mean, I'm about to be gone too. So, you know what I mean, but yeah, I'm definitely gonna miss Hightower. But I didn't talk to him about the transfer thing. But I mean, the other guys, we talked in the room. We were talking, you know, like you know, he was a sophomore. Mm-hmm. You know, like Wiggs is a sophomore, Pope is a sophomore, Harley's a junior, and you know, kind of what Coach was saying, like, you know, in my situation, you know, coming to another school and playing right away, he said, you know, that's actually rare. So, you know, those guys, I mean, it's not that you have to be patient, but, you know, their time is coming. You know, like, I played 3 years at Buffalo before I got here. So, I think, and it's like that, you know, everywhere. You know, when you come in, if it's not going the way you want it, I mean, high school, you used to, you know, right now. And the same thing, I feel like every freshman, like, when I was a freshman, I thought I should be playing, or I thought I should be doing more, this, that. But, you know, just stay the course, you know, trust your coaches and stuff like that, and it'll come around. I feel like that's what I tell these guys, too. Even, like, before that, I was telling them, them guys are so young, and they're so good, so young. But I just said, stay the course, and them guys will be amazing players.
Hey, KJ, Coach didn't tell us who was starting. I know you like both quarterbacks, but how do you feel at this point with their situations and medical, their health and all that? What do you think of each one?
They're both out there fighting. They're both out there fighting. Both Jaren and Kosi, you know, have tremendous strength, as I think Coach Eno's touched on. But, you know, we're just going to go with, you know, whoever Coach calls, and we'll be ready for that.
The other thing I wanted to ask, I've asked a couple of the other guys, in the past, if the program or the team has started losing a few games or the season's not going as well, sometimes it spirals kind of out of control.
Right.
How do you help? I know you're one of the leaders and you're kind of new here. How do you help that from happening? How do you prevent that from happening?
You know, just continue to work hard and preach that. And I feel like that can come from the top down. We have a great head coach, and, you know, Coach Diaz touched on that too. Some things that happened here in the past in Miami, but he said, you know, you just got to keep working, keep going. It's small plays. It's like little details. You know, some people ask me, I feel like I had a 6-6 year at Buffalo, and it would remind me a lot of this team. And one of our coaches, he always used to say, like, the difference. And he put this picture up like this. And I feel like that's a lot with this team. Like, it's like 3 or 4 plays, we could be undefeated. And it's crazy. So, I mean, we got to just keep working and keep executing, coming out here and keep working every day, and just having a pride about you.
Two more questions. I want to ask you your thoughts on the Pitt defense, just what you see from watching them.
They have, like, a pretty base defense. I know their coach, he came from Michigan State a couple of years ago, played some cover 4, cover 1, some man, and a lot of different things. But as a pretty base, like, not real, like, kind of vanilla, like, they're just going to line up and do what they do.
They're aggressive.
Yeah. I mean, at corner, you know, it's kind of different, you know, like, with the technique, you know, they may not give you, like, too much hands, but you mean, like, from, like, the blitzing and stuff like that. Yeah, but.
Generally, yeah.
Yeah. All right.